Good morning, student. Yes, I hope you are all well. You already informed that on behalf of management of Bardhaman Model School, yes, and with the help of Anandavarta, we arrange the online class. In the last week, I take the class of class 12, the chapter Hello Alkane and Hello Arene. In that class, I discuss about the preparation of the different types of Hello Alkane. Now, in this class, I shall discuss about the physical and chemical properties of haloalkane. First, we discuss about the physical properties of haloalkane. Physical properties of haloalkane. What are the physical properties of haloalkane? First, you remember that all haloalkanes except CH3Br, CH3Cl, CH3F, C2H5Br, all haloalkane up to carbon number 18 are exist in the oily liquid with a pleasant smell. The except some lower haloalkane like CH3Br, CH3Cl, CH3F, all other haloalkane up to carbon number 18 exist as a oily pleasant smell liquid. The haloalkane with carbon number greater than 18 exists in the solid state. Number in the terms of physical property, first we discuss melting point. Melting point and boiling point of haloalkane are generally higher than the corresponding hydrocarbon. Melting point and boiling point of haloalkane are generally higher than the corresponding haloalkane. Why the melting point is higher? Because you know that carbon halogen bond, this carbon halogen bond is polar in nature due to greater electronegativity of carbon atom. Due to polar character, there is dipole-dipole interaction in haloalkane. This dipole-dipole interaction is stronger than van der Waal force that is present in hydrocarbon. So haloalkane have higher boiling point or melting point. So high melting point of haloalkane is due to dipole-dipole interaction of C-X bond. This dipole-dipole interaction is stronger than van der Waal force. The boiling point increase in the order R-F greater than R-Cl greater than R-Br greater than R-I. This is the order of increasing the boiling point. That is, iodide either have highest boiling point or melting point, and fluoride either lowest boiling point or melting point. This is due to greater polarity of the bond of Ri bond, and iodine have very larger size with high molecular mass. So in case of Ri, both the van der Waal force and dipole-dipole interaction are stronger. If you take halogen halide of the same halogen, say CH3Cl, CH2Cl2, CHCl3 and CCl4, with increase in number of halogen, boiling point also increases. So with if the number of halogen in a haloalkane increase, then boiling point also increase. So this is the first point, melting point and boiling point. Number two, under the physical properties, is the dipole moment. Dipole moment. What is dipole moment? You know the product of the polarity of the bond and the bond length is called dipole moment. That you have learned in class 11, the dipole moment mu equal to E into L. Now in haloalkane, the carbon halogen bond is polar. So carbon halogen bond is polar. So there will be some value of E, and the product of bond length is equal to dipole moment. Now what is the order of dipole moment of haloalkane? It has been observed that RCl has the highest dipole moment, then RF, then RBr, then RI. You must remember this order of dipole moment. This is an exceptional order. RF, though the fluorine is most electronegative, so carbon fluorine bond is most polar, Yet RCL have higher dipole moment than RF. Why? Due to the very small bond length of CF bond. CF bond is very smaller, which outweighs the electronegativity difference between carbon and fluorine. So RCL is the most, have most dipole moment, and RI has the least dipole moment. Next is the solubility. What is the solubility? Though halogen alkyl halide are polar in nature, but it is insoluble in water. Why? Because they cannot form hydrogen bond with water molecule. Now, for the solubility of haloalkane in water, you have to break the bond between the haloalkane, and you have to break the bond between the water molecule. Now, energy required to break the bond between the haloalkane and to break the hydrogen bond present in water is much greater than energy formed but released during the formation of new bond. So due to this, haloalkane cannot form hydrogen bond with water molecule. So haloalkane are insoluble in water. They are insoluble in water, but soluble in non-polar solvent like chloroform or carbon disulfide or acetone. In this type of non-polar solvent, they are soluble, but they are not soluble in polar solvent because it cannot form hydrogen bond with water molecule. So these are the some physical properties of haloalkane. First, haloalkane have higher melting point, boiling point. This is due to greater dipole-dipole, in stronger force of dipole-dipole interaction. Number two, haloalkane have dipole moment. You must remember this exceptional order. Chloride has higher dipole moment than fluoride. This is due to shorter bond length of carbon fluorine. And haloalkane are insoluble in polar solvent but soluble in water, and soluble in non-polar solvent like carbon disulfide, ethanol, acetone, and so on. So these are the physical properties of haloalkane. Next, we discuss about the chemical properties of haloalkane. So next point, chemical properties of haloalkane. Chemical properties. First, you remember that due to polarity of the carbon halogen bond, due to polarity of carbon halogen bond, haloalkane are most mass reactive than corresponding hydrocarbon. Haloalkane are mass reactive than corresponding hydrocarbon. This is due to polarity of Cl bond. Cx bond is polar. Cx bond is polar. Partial negative charge on halogen atom and partial positive charge on carbon atom. Due to this polar nature, haloalkane is mass reactive in nature. It undergo three types of reaction. Number one, nucleophilic substitution reaction. Nucleophilic substitution reaction. Number two, elimination reaction. Elimination reaction. And number three, reaction with metal. Reaction with metal. Reaction with metal. So these are the three types of reaction that haloalkane undergo. First is the nucleophilic substitution reaction. That means you know that halide ion is very weak nucleophile. Why? The halide ion is very weak base. If you consider the Cl minus ion or I minus ion or Br minus ion, what is their conjugate acid? HCl, HI, HBr. Now you have already informed in ionic equilibrium that stronger the acid, weaker will be conjugate base. Now HCl, HI, HBr, all are stronger acid, so their conjugate base is very weak. So due to very weak nature of halide ion, they can be replaced by a strong halide, strong nucleophile. Hence they undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. When a stronger nucleophile, for example OH minus or NH2 or SH minus or C2H5OH are react with halogen, alkyl halide, then halogen atom are replaced by this strong nucleophile. You first see some example of nucleophilic substitution reaction. Say this is an haloalkane C2H5Br. This haloalkane, say when it reacts with aqueous KOH, then Br is replaced by OH minus ion to form C2H5OH plus KBr. This is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Here Br is a OH minus is a nucleophile, is replaced Br. When it reacts with ammonia in a sealed tube, at 373 Kelvin, that is 100 degree centigrade, then halogen atom is replaced by amine group plus HBr. This amine group then again reacts with another alkyl halide to form a secondary amine C2H5 whole 2 NH, which again reacts with another alkyl halide to form a tertiary amine. So this is the nucleophilic substitution reaction. Another example of reaction, when it reacts with alcoholic KCN, potassium cyanide, alcoholic KCN, then Br is replaced by CN to form C2H5CN plus KBr. When it reacts with alcoholic AgCN, silver cyanide, then it forms isocyanide C2H5NC plus AgBr. Now here a question arises: with the alcoholic KCN, the cyanide is formed, but with the alcoholic AgCN, isocyanide is formed. Why? Why different product is formed if we use KCN and AgCN? I will discuss later. First see the reaction. It reacts with potassium nitrite KNO2 to form alkene nitrite C2H5ONO plus KBr. But when it reacts with silver nitrite AgNO2, it forms nitro compound C2H5ONO2 plus AgBr. When it reacts with alkoxide C2H5ONA, it forms ether C2H5O C2H5 plus NaBr. When it reacts with thiool, sodium hydrogen sulfide NaSH, it forms C2H5SH thiool plus NaBr. These are some example of nucleophilic substitution reaction. That is, Br is replaced by either OH or NH2 or CN or NO2 or ONA or SH. All are better nucleophile than ClBr minus or Cl minus. So it undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now this question: why with alcoholic KCN C2H5Br gives cyanide ion, but with alcoholic AgCN it gives isocyanide ion? Why it give different product? This is due to the nature of the ligand CN minus. CN minus, if you write this in this way, then it is minus, and if you write in this way, then it is minus. That is, both carbon atom and nitrogen atom acts as a donor center. This type of nucleophile is called ambidentate nucleophile. Now, in case of alcoholic KCN, potassium cyanide is a ionic compound, so it dissociates to form K plus and CN minus. The CN minus is a two resonating form. Here carbon acts as a donor center, also nitrogen acts as a donor tensor. If carbon acts as a donor center, then CC bond is formed, or if nitrogen acts as a donor center, then NC bond is formed. Now CC bond is stronger than NC bond. So cyanide will be the major product. That is, potassium cyanide is a ionic compound. It dissociates into K plus and CN minus. This CN minus is an ambidentine ligand. That is, if you draw the resonance structure of CN minus, in one case carbon acts as a donor center, in another case nitrogen acts as a donor center. This type of ligand is called ambidentine ligand. Now if so, the carbon atom can form with carbon to form CC bond, and carbon atom can form nitrogen to form CN bond. Carbon atom can form nitrogen to form CN bond. Now CC bond is stronger than CN bond, so cyanide will be the major product. But in case of AgCN, it is mainly a covalent compound, so it does not dissociate to form CN minus ion. If it is covalent compound, then nitrogen acts only at the donor center. So this lone pair electron and nitrogen form a bond with carbon atom. So isocyanide NC will be the major product. So main reason for this different product is the nature of the bond of KCN and AgCN. KCN is a ionic bond, so CN acts as a ambidentine ligand. Both carbon and nitrogen acts as a donor center. But AgCN is a covalent bond, so it does not dissociate to form CN minus ion. So nitrogen acts only as a donor center. So lone pair electron of nitrogen combine with carbon atom to form NC bond. For the same reason, KNO2 is a ambidentine ligand. NO2 minus either ONO, then oxygen is a donor center, or ekhane nitrogen is a donor center. Potassium nitrite is a ionic compound. So it dissociates to form NO2 minus. Here nitrogen is a donor center, or if you write ONO, then oxygen is a donor center. That is, NO2 is also an ambidentine ligand. Now due to the ionic nature, the oxygen acts as a donor center, and carbon oxygen bond is stronger than carbon nitrogen bond. So ONO will be the major product. But in case of AgNO2, it is a covalent compound. So here nitrogen, lone pair electron of nitrogen only acts as a donor center, so NO2 will be the major product. So these are the different types of nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now in the different types of nucleophilic substitution reaction, if you notice the mechanism of this reaction, it has two types of nucleophilic substitution reaction. One is called SN1 reaction. So nucleophilic substitution reaction are two types. One is called SN1 and another is called SN2, SN1 and SN2. You have already informed about SN1 and SN2 in class 11 in the mechanism portion, that is basic concept of organic. Now what is SN1 and SN2? This is very important for class 12. SN1 means substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. One means unimolecular, and SN2 means substitution nucleophilic bimolecular. Now these two types of reaction, SN1 and SN2. SN1 means substitution nucleophilic unimolecular reaction. Now what is this reaction? Tertiary alkyl halide mainly undergo SN1 reaction. Consider this reaction, CH3CH3CH3Br. This is the tertiary alkyl bromide. Now when this reacts with aqueous KOH, Br is replaced by OH, then what will be product? CH3CH3COH+KBr. Now kinetically it has been observed that rate of the reaction equal to concentration of alkyl halide, that means Rate of the reaction depends on the concentration of alkyl halide. Rate is independent of the concentration of aqueous KOH. That means the reaction takes place in two steps. In the rate determining step, that is in the slowest step, only the tertiary alkyl halide involved. In the next step, that is the first step, the aqueous KOH is involved. So, since the rate of the reaction depends only on the tertiary alkyl halide, so this is called unimolecular reaction. That is, rate depends only on the one molecule. Rate does not depend on aqueous KOH. So, it is called unimolecular reaction. So, what will be the mechanism of the reaction? In the first step, the breakage of carbon halogen bond take place, that is CH3, this is beer, this bond dissociate to form a carbocation, CH3 whole 3 C plus beer minus, this is the slow step. So, rate determining step, so first step is the formation of a carbocation, In the next step, that is second step, that is the first step, this carbocation, you know that carbocation have planar shape, the OH minus ion attack at this carbocation, this is the first step to form an alcohol, CH3 whole 3 COH. So, this is the two step reaction. In the slow step, only the tertiary alkyl halide involved. In the next step, the OH minus ion attack the positive charge of carbocation to form an alcohol. Now, you consider this intermediate carbocation is a planar in shape. You know that carbocation, carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. So, it is planar in shape. Due to planar shape, the nucleophile can attack both from front side and also from the back side. So, if the alkyl halide is optically active, then the product may be either dextro or levo. So, racemization takes place in case of SN1 reaction. Because in SN1, the intermediate carbocation is a planar shape, so the nucleophile can attack both from the back side as well as from the front side. So, both dextro and levo product can be obtained. So, if the original alkyl halide is the optically active, say dextro compound, then the product may be a mixture of dextro and levo, that is racemization take place in case of SN1 reaction. Now, SN1 reaction favored by the formation of carbocation. So, SN1 reaction will increase with the increase in stability of the carbocation. If the intermediate carbocation is more stable, then it mainly undergo SN1 reaction. Now, you know that primary carbocation is the least stable. So, primary alkyl halide does not undergo SN1 reaction. So, what will be the order of reactivity towards SN1 reaction? First, benzylic. Because benzylic carbocation is stabilized by resonance. Then, allylic. It is also stabilized by resonance. Then, 3 degree. Then 2 degree, then 1 degree, then methyl. This is the order of reactivity towards SN1 reaction. Benzylic and allylic carbocation is stabilized by resonance. So, they mainly undergo SN1 reaction. For example, consider this reaction. Benzene ring CH2Br. Benzyl bromide. When treated with aqueous KOH, it forms benzyl alcohol CH2OH. Though this bromine attached to the primary carbon atom, but it undergo SN1 mechanism. Why it undergo SN1 mechanism? Because the intermediate carbocation this form, this is stabilized by resonance, so it undergo SN1 mechanism. So, this is the order of reactivity towards SN1 reaction. Benzylic greater than allylic, greater than 3, greater than 2, greater than 1, greater than methyl. Now, SN1 reaction, the stability of the carbocation is a major factor. Now, carbocation stability increases in polar solvent. So, polar solvent favors the SN1 reaction. That is, if water medium is present, it favors SN1 reaction. The weak nucleophile and low concentration of nucleophile favors the SN1 reaction. So what are the characteristics of SN1 reaction? First, SN1 reaction take place in two steps. The intermediate carbocation is formed. Next, the order of reactivity of SN1 3° > 2° > 1°. Next point, the polar solvent favors the stability of carbocation, so favors the SN1 reaction. Next point, the weak nucleophile and low concentration of nucleophile favors SN1 reaction. SN1 reaction is favored by steric factor. SN1 reaction favored by electronic factor. Electronic factor increase the stability of the carbocation. So electronic factor favors the SN1 reaction. If the alkyl halide is optically active, then racemization take place due to SN1 reaction. So these are the major characteristics of SN1 reaction. Now next I will discuss about the SN2 reaction. What is SN2 reaction? SN2 means substitution nucleophilic bimolecular. SN2, substitution nucleophilic bimolecular. Primary alkyl halide or methyl halide mainly undergo SN2 reaction. Kinetically, say CH3Br, CH3Br reacts with aqueous KOH, to form CH3OH. Plus KBr. Now kinetically it has been found that rate of the reaction is proportional to concentration of alkyl halide as well as concentration of OH minus. Kinetically it has been observed that if we in double the concentration of methyl bromide, rate of the reaction also become double, and if we double the concentration of aqueous KOH, then also rate of the reaction become double. That is, rate depends both on alkyl halide and OH minus ion. That is, both molecule involved in rate determining step. So it is called bimolecular, SN2, that is bimolecular, because in the rate determining step both alkyl halide and the nucleophile are involved, which suggests that reaction take place in one step. For the single step, what is the reaction? In the single CH3Br plus KOH, what will be the product? In the transition set, the carbon halogen bond partially dissociate, and from the backside carbon OH bond partially form. This is called transition state, that is 3 full bond and 2 half bond. So in the SN2 reaction, in the slowest step, the carbon halogen bond partially dissociate and the nucleophile can approach always from the back side to form carbon OH bond. Nucleophile always approach back side, because if nucleophile approach from front side, there will be repulsion between two nucleophile. So in the transition state, the carbon halogen bond dissociate partially, and from the back side the carbon nucleophile bond partially form. In the next step, the Br eliminate to form this alcohol plus Br minus. So this will be the reaction of SN2 reaction. Now you observe, if this 3 group here, hydrogen atom, that is very small size, so nucleophile can easily approach from back side. If this is the bulky group, say CH3, this is also CH3 bulky group. Due to presence of bulky group, there is mass steric hindrance, so nucleophile cannot approach from back side. So tertiary alkyl halide does not undergo SN2 mechanism due to steric factor. Due to presence of 3 bulky group, the nucleophile cannot approach from backside, so it does not undergo SN2 reaction. So what will be order of SN2 reaction? 1° methyl halide is the most reactive towards SN2 reaction, then 1°, then 2°, then 3°. That is, SN2 reaction is governed by steric factor. Greater the steric hindrance of the bulky group, less will be reactivity towards SN2 mechanism. Why? Because the bulky group, if present in the carbon atom, then it hinder the approach of nucleophile from the backside. Now SN2 reaction favor in nonpolar solvent. SN1 reaction favor in the polar solvent. SN2 reaction favors in the nonpolar solvent, and the nucleophile, stronger nucleophile with high concentration favors the SN2 mechanism. SN1 mechanism favored by weak nucleophile and low concentration. SN2 mechanism favored by strong nucleophile with high concentration. SN2 হচ্ছে one step reaction, SN1 two step reaction. Now you consider if this alkyl halide is optically active, say this is the dextro compound D plus. Now during SN2 mechanism, the nucleophile always approach from the backside, so this will be L minus. This is known as inversion of configuration. Inversion of configuration. So SN2 reaction always take place by inversion of configuration. Why? Because SN2 reaction, the nucleophile always approach from the backside. Since SN2 reaction nucleophile always approach from backside, so if a compound is optically active halide, say it is dextro compound, then the alcohol produced will be the levo compound. This is known as inversion of configuration. So SN2 reaction always proceed by the inversion of configuration, whereas SN1 reaction proceed by the racemization. So this is the main point of SN2 reaction, that is SN2 reaction take place in one step by the formation of intermediate transition state. In transition state, carbon halogen bond partially dissociate, and from the backside the carbon nucleophile bond partially form. So now if we compare the SN1 and SN2, then what will be the comparison between SN1 and SN2? SN1, the order of reactivity tertiary greater than secondary greater than primary. SN2, order of reactivity reverse, that is 1 degree greater than 2 degree greater than 3 degree. In SN1 reaction, the rate of the reaction depends upon concentration of alkyl halide only, that is unimolecular. In SN2, rate of the reaction depends both on the concentration of alkyl halide as well as aqueous KOH. SN1 reaction favored by polar solvent, SN2 reaction favored by non-polar solvent. SN1 reaction favored by weak nucleophile with low concentration of nucleophile. SN2 reaction favored by strong nucleophile with high concentration of nucleophile. Since SN1 reaction take place via the formation of carbocation, so rearrangement of carbocation may take place in order to increase the stability. So unexpected product can be formed in SN1 reaction. SN1 reaction favored by the formation of carbocation. Now carbocation may undergo rearrangement to get a greater stable carbocation, so an unexpected product can be obtained in SN1 reaction. But SN2 reaction, there is no chance of unexpected product. SN1 reaction, the racemization take place. SN2, inversion of configuration take place. Give an example of unexpected product by SN1 mechanism. Unexpected product, consider this reaction CH3CH2Br. Now this alkyl halide is a primary alkyl halide, but it undergo SN1 mechanism. Why? First, in the slow step, this bond dissociate, this is a slow step. What will be the carbocation? CH3CH2+. Now this is the 1 degree carbocation. Now in order to increase the stability, the 1,2 methyl shift take place. Methyl shift, that is this methyl group shift here to form 3 degree carbocation. CH3C CH3 CH2 CH3, this is the tertiary carbocation. This is known as 1,2 methyl shift, that is carbocation undergo rearrangement to obtain the greater stability. In the next step, that is the first step, the OH minus ion attack this carbocation to form this product CH3C CH3 OH CH2 CH3. That is, and if we consider the normal product, the Br should be replaced by OH here, but OH come here and CH3 come there. This is an unexpected product. This unexpected product is obtained due to 1,2 methyl shift. Why 1,2 methyl shift take place? in order to increase the stability of the carbocation. So these are the nucleophilic substitution reaction. In the next, I will discuss about the elimination reaction. Elimination reaction means removal of hydrogen and halogen. Consider this reaction, CH3CH2Br. When heated with alcoholic KOH, it gives CH2 double bond CH2. That is, hydrogen and halogen eliminate to form HBr plus KOH, gives KBr plus water. This is called elimination reaction. If you take a tertiary alkyl halide, CH3CBr, when it reacts with alcoholic KOH, at a heat korte hobe, heat, it gives CH3 double bond CH2 plus KBr plus water. This is known as beta elimination reaction. Why it is called beta elimination reaction? Because halogen, if halogen remove from the alpha carbon atom, then hydrogen always remove from the beta carbon atom. So this type of reaction is known as beta elimination reaction. Now, during beta elimination reaction, if consider this alkyl halide CH3, now when heated with alcoholic KOH, the two product may be obtained. Say this is the Br, this is alpha carbon with respect to this, this is also beta carbon and this is also beta carbon. That is, bromine is eliminated from alpha carbon, and if eliminated from this carbon, this beta carbon, then what will be product? CH3CH2CH double bond CH2, that is but one in. And if bromine is eliminated from alpha carbon and hydrogen from this beta carbon, then what will be product? CH3CH double bond CH CH3, that is but two in. Now this is the major product. Eta pray 80% pa jay, eta hocche 19% or 20% moto paoa jacche. Now during the dehalogenation of alkyl halide by alcoholic KOH, if two different alkene is produced, then what will be the major product? That is given by Sedgefs rule, SAYTZEFFS, Sedgefs rule. According to this rule, the more substituted alkene will be the major product. Which is more substituted alkene? More substituted alkene means the alkene which contain greater number of methyl group. If you consider but 2-in, this is the carbon-carbon double bond, two methyl group is present. So there is 3 plus 3, 6 alpha hydrogen is present. So there is 6 possible hyperconjugative structure. But but 1-in, this is the 2 alpha hydrogen. So there is 2 possible hyperconjugative structure. That is but 2-in is more stable than but 1-in, so it will be the major product. Now if this alkene is geometrical isomer, that is cis form and trans form. Now but 2-in have both cis form and trans form, then trans form will be the major product due to less steric hindrance. And trans form er dutto methyl group opposite dike ache, therefore the steric hindrance is minimum. So if the alkene produced have short geometrical isomerism, then transform will be the major product. So this is the Sedgefs rule. That is, what is the Sedgefs rule? The if during the dehydrohalogenation of alkyl halide by alcoholic KOH, two different alkene is obtained, then the alkene which have more substituted alkene, that is alkene which have greater number of methyl group, will be the major product. Now this elimination reaction are also two types, EN1 and EN2, and like SN1 and SN2, tertiary alkyl halide undergo EN1 mechanism, and primary alkyl halide undergo E2 or EN2 mechanism. It is like SN1 mechanism, that in the first step, that is the slow step, the carbocation is formed, CH3 CH3 plus in the carbocation is formed. This is the slow step, like SN1 in EN1. In the next step, one of the proton is abstract by the OH minus ion to form a double bond. CH3 double bond CH. It was a first step. Like SN1 in EN1 also, the carbocation is formed in the first step. Now in the next step, the beta hydrogen is extracted by the nucleophile. Nucleophile abstract a beta hydrogen to form an alkene. This is a EN1, that is tertiary alkyl halide mainly undergo EN1 mechanism. In case of primary alkyl halide, that is EN2, primary alkyl halide, the CH2Br. This bond dissociate and the nucleophile also attack this bond in the, this is a transition state. That is, in the transition state, both carbon halogen bond dissociate and the beta hydrogen is abstract by the nucleophile. Nucleophile abstract the beta hydrogen to form CH2 double bond CH2. That is, reaction take place in one step. In the transition state, at the same time, carbon halogen bond dissociate and the beta hydrogen also abstract by the nucleophile to form an alkene. Now, here the question arises, the alkyl halide, when reacts with aqueous KOH, it gives the undergo substitution reaction, and alkyl halide, when reacts with alcoholic KOH, it gives the elimination reaction. So, in which case elimination favor and in which case substitution favor, that depend upon four factor. So, elimination versus substitution, it depend upon four factor. This number one. Number one, look, temperature. Normally, high temperature favors the elimination reaction and low temperature favors the substitution reaction. Ekta alkyl halide, jodi ami temperature bariye di, tale elimination reaction ta favor korbe, ar temperature low korle, substitution reaction favor korbe. Number two, nature of solvent. Polar solvent favors the substitution reaction and non-polar solvent favors the elimination reaction. If the solvent is polar, tale ki hobe substitution reaction ta favor korche. Jemon dhor aqueous KOH, the solvent is polar, or alcoholic KOH, solvent is non-polar, so it favors the elimination reaction. So polar solvent favors the substitution reaction and non-polar solvent favors the elimination reaction. Number three, nature of alkyl halide. Normally, tertiary alkyl halide, that is alkyl halide with greater bulky group, favors the elimination reaction. Our primary alkyl halide, that is alkyl halide with the smaller group, favors the substitution reaction. If bulky group is present in the alkyl halide, then the nucleophile cannot approach toward the alkyl halide. So, tertiary alkyl halide favors the elimination reaction and primary alkyl halide favors the substitution reaction. In general, if bulky group is present in the alkyl halide, it favors the elimination reaction. And number four, nature of nucleophile. Stronger nucleophile with bulky size favors elimination reaction. Stronger nucleophile with bulky size favors elimination reaction and weaker nucleophile with smaller size favors substitution reaction. For example, when you take C2H5Br aqueous KOH, it forms C2H5OH. Why? Here the nucleophile key, nucleophile hoche OH minus. It is the weaker and also the smaller size. But when reacts with alcoholic KOH, it form elimination reaction to form C2H. Alcoholic means you take C2H5OH plus KOH, it gives C2H5O minus, This nucleophile is stronger than OH and bulkier size, so it undergo elimination reaction. So these are the four factors which favors the whether the reaction take place substitution or elimination. The high temperature favors the elimination reaction, polar solvent favors substitution reaction, non-polar solvent favors elimination reaction, primary alkyl halide favors substitution reaction, tertiary alkyl halide with bulky group favors elimination reaction, or larger size bulky nucleophile favors elimination reaction, and smaller nucleophile favors the substitution reaction. Last third type of reaction that I have discussed is the reaction with metal. Reaction with metal. Reaction with metal. Alkyl halide reacts with metal. Number one, first in very important reaction, formation of Grignard reagent. Grignard. Its general formula is RMgX. Grignard reagent. Alkyl halide, say C2H5Cl, reacts with magnesium in presence of dry ether to form C2H5MgBr. This is a Grignard reagent. So alkyl halide reacts with magnesium in presence of dry ether to form Grignard reagent. This is very important compound in organic chemistry. It reacts with either water or alcohol or alkyne, this to give alkane. It also reacts with aldehyde or ketone to give alcohol. Very important organic reagent. Number two reaction, Wahr's reaction. You have already learned in class 11, Wahr's reaction. Alkyl halide, say CH3I, reacts with sodium, two molecule alkyl halide in presence of dry ether. Why we take dry ether? Because sodium does not react with ether to form an alkane, CH3CH3 plus 2NaI. The reaction is known as Wahr's reaction, and this reaction is used to prepare alkane. Normally, alkane with even number of carbon atom, that is ethane, butane, hexane, octane, that can be easily prepared by Wahr's reaction. But alkyl halide with odd number of carbon atom cannot be prepared by Wahr's reaction, because say you have to prepare the propane, then what will be alkyl halide? CH3I plus 2Na plus C2H5I, dry ether. The product will be C2H5 propane. Along with propane, they react with each other to form ethane, and this react with each other to form butane. That is, three alkane is obtained, propane, butane and ethane, and it is very difficult to separate each other. So alkane with odd number of carbon atom cannot be prepared by Wahr's reaction. Number three, Frankland reaction. Here alkyl halide, say C2H5Br, reacts with zinc, two molecule alkyl halide, to form dialkyl zinc C2H5 whole 2 Zn plus ZnBr2. This reaction is known as Frankland reaction. Alkyl halide reacts with zinc to form dialkyl zinc and ZnBr2. This reaction is known as Frankland reaction. Next reaction, alkyl halide C2H5Br reacts with sodium lead alloy to form C2H5 whole 4 Pb. This is called tetraethyl lead, but tail bola hoy tetraethyl lead, jeta ekta somete petrol e use kora hoto to increase the efficiency of fuel. Teso eta anti knocking agent ekta tetraethyl lead. So these are some reaction of alkyl halide with metal. alkyl halide reacts with grignard magnesium to form grignardiazen. Alkyl halide is a grignardiazen. Now you consider that this is grignardiazen RMGX. It reacts with water to form alkane RH plus MgxOH. MgxOH. That is, we can obtain alkane from grignardiazen. We can obtain alcohol from also grignardiazen. We can get acid from grignardiazen. So it is a very important organic reagent. Number 2 is a Bhardt reaction. Where the alkyl halide reacts with sodium in presence of ether to form alkane. Number 3 is a Frankland reaction. Where alkyl halide reacts with zinc to form dialkyl zinc. And last is a tetraethyl lead. That is an anti-knocking agent. Earlier it is used in the petrol, but now it is not used in the petrol due to its pollution power, because lead is very poisonous in nature. So these are some important reaction of alkyl halide. So alkyl halide is more reactive. Why alkyl halide is more reactive? This is due to polar nature of carbon halogen bond. Alkyl halide undergo three types of reaction. First source substitution reaction, nucleophilic substitution reaction. Next source elimination reaction. Our third one hoche tor reaction with metal. Substitution reaction again two types. Ekta hoche SN1 or ekta hoche SN2. You must remember what is the SN1 reaction, what is SN2 reaction, their comparison and their optical behavior. In optically, if an alkyl halide is optically active and if it undergo SN1 reaction, then the product is racemization. That is, the product may be both dextro and levo. But if the alkyl halide is optically active and undergo SN2 reaction, then inversion of configuration take place. Yes. Now another important question that I have already discussed, you must remember the why alkyl halide reacts with potassium cyanide to form alkyl cyanide, whereas when it reacts with silver cyanide, it form alkyl isocyanide. This is because potassium cyanide is a ionic compound, so Cn minus acts as an ambivalent ligand, both carbon and nitrogen acts as a nucleophile donor center. Now CC bond is stronger than Cn bond, so cyanide is major product. But silver cyanide is a covalent compound, so nitrogen acts only as a donor center, so isocyanide will be the major product. Now this cyanide, this is very important compound. Why? Say this is the alkyl cyanide, UPPR from alkyl halide. It undergo reduction in presence of lithium aluminium hydride to form primary amine RCH2NH2. It undergo partial hydrolysis in presence of concentrated HCl to form amide RCONH2, or it undergo complete hydrolysis in presence of dilute HCl to form acid. That is, from cyanide we can get primary amine or amide or acid. So this is a very important organic compound that can be prepared from alkyl halide. So today I will discuss about the chemical nature and physical properties of alkyl halide. In the next class I shall discuss about the haloarene, that is chlorobenzene, bromobenzene or fluorobenzene. Yes, so this is a haloalkane. In the next class, I will discuss about the haloarene, their mode of preparation and their chemical reactivity. Today's 10 minutes.